Hey, what's up everyone, and once again, welcome back to Mario Kart 8. So, last time, we finished up the 50cc for DLC Pack 2, doing the Bell Cup, and this time we're going to be jumping into 100cc, we're going to be using Isabelle, third if you count both villagers, DLC Pack 2 character, using the City Tripper, the Leaf Tires, and the Paper Glider. There is, interesting stats. We've got a lot of handling, no speed whatsoever, but This could be interesting. I'm going to be doing the 100cc Crossing Cup with GCN Baby Park, GBA, Cheeseland, Wild Woods, and Animal Crossing. So let's get started. Yeah, these videos feel like they don't take that long to record. I don't know. Maybe it's because whenever I was recording the original friggin' Mario Kart 8 LP, it was like, what was it? Like, everything. Like, eight cups in every, what is it? 8 cups in every single, CC. God, I can't get my words out. Now I'm only recording 2 cups in every CC. And so when we get to friggin' 200cc, that's gonna be something. Also, Isabelle is kind of adorable. And then as I say that, she smiles. That was so cute. Again, never played Animal Crossing New Leaf. Never played Animal Crossing in general. It really doesn't seem like my type of game. Aha, you should have fired that earlier, Wendy. However, I will openly admit, some of the characters from Animal Crossing are freaking adorable. So, yeah. Also, I forgot how slow 50cc actually was, because I know we're only in 100cc right now, but this already feels so much faster. I don't know. I could have just skipped 100cc like I said, but nah. We're not gonna do that. We're gonna cover everything in this game. Okay. Every single thing in this game, because it's so damn good. Now, I realized in the 50cc run of this course, is that coming for me? See, that's a thing. I can never tell what's coming for me and what isn't. Don't drive into the wall. I didn't talk about the stuff around the edges. Look, that Ferris wheel right there. Oh, I'm in third. Who is in first? Okay, they were. The Ferris wheel at the back there is based on the Ferris wheel from Mario Sunshine, I believe. Though at least it looks sort of like it, which I think is a nice little detail because Double Dash was out on the GameCube at the same time as Mario Sunshine, so I stopped drifting there for some reason. So it's a nice touch. You can also see Luigi's Mansion over there, which is pretty cool. I'm guessing it's some kind of ghost house. Yoshi's flying egg, I think, there. Bowser's ship, with Bowser Jr. on it, may I add. Also, I was looking over at the side and I didn't see whatever I just hit. With Bowser Jr. on it, why is Bowser Jr. on there but not a character in this game? Where is my Bowser Jr. and my Diddy Kong? I don't know. I feel like they tried to make this look like Disney, because there's the little grass thing over there with a mushroom on it. I believe somewhere there's, I could be wrong here. But I think there's like a statue outside of a castle, and it's supposed to represent, or it looks sort of like Walt Disney and Mickey outside the front of Disney. Maybe I'm crazy, but, or maybe that's just what the pink gold baby peach is. If you didn't notice, there was a pink gold baby peach statue. New character confirmed, maybe? I hope not. Pink gold baby peach, that would be even worse than adding pink gold peach. Just because we got pink gold peach, let's make a baby form. And then let's make a pink gold baby form of pink gold baby peach. I don't know. It's too many things. Oh, we got a mushroom. I want to take a shortcut. Alright. Friggin' Bowser screwed me up there. Thank you, Bowser. But there was a shortcut there. I think this course actually has, it has a couple, like, glider-based shortcuts. Maybe. Because I don't think we do that much gliding in this. Well, I say that as we get to a glider shortcut. I imagine in 200cc you can just skip this whole corner, but where is it? Yeah, like right there. You got a mushroom, you go on that glider thing, you cut over that gap, and then I believe after that gap, there is, yeah, you see right there in front of me, there's another glider portion, so you can actually go up there right after the first one. So I kind of want a mushroom, but I'm in first. I'm like front running right now. Maybe, you know what I said earlier about 50cc just being slower and not necessarily easier? Maybe they do change that, because, I mean, in multiplayer, you have the option to change the CPU difficulty. So surely it would make sense that that's how the Grand Prix work, but at the same time, if the CPUs were as easy as they are in 50cc in, say, 200cc, it would be easy. I don't know. Maybe they do up the difficulty. That's not ever something I've really thought about. But, huh. Let me know what you guys think. I'm not entirely sure, and we actually hit the chain chomp. Okay. That's, like, the first time that's happened. Also, I know I say also, like, all the time. The like, toad houses that you can see around, they're designed to look like, I guess, desert houses. Like, the houses people who live in the desert live in, I guess. Do people live in the desert? I don't know. I've never really lived in a desert, so I wouldn't know. But, they're designed to, oh, it's also like cheese houses and stuff, to look like that. But because this course, at first glance, you'd be like, oh, they're adding another desert course. Then you look again, and it's got cheese everywhere. That was my first reaction, actually, to this course when I saw it in, like, its own trailer. I was like, oh, maybe they're doing dry ruins or something like that. And then I saw a giant block of cheese. So, yeah. Because it was the Japanese trailer, and I don't speak Japanese, so I didn't know it said Cheeseland, but I don't know. I like Cheeseland. It's not the best course in the DLC pack, but I like it. And I like Isabelle. Look at her. Friggin' dancing around. So cute. She's wagging her tail, for God's sake. That's adorable. I don't know. I don't know much about Animal Crossing. Oh, my voice. All I know is that Isabelle is, like, a person in Animal Crossing, and she appears in Smash as an assist trophy. That's all I know. Anyway, Crossing Cup Wild Woods. I still love this course. I mean, we only just played it 2 videos ago, but I love this course. It's such a good course, and I'm gonna go ahead and gush about it again. Gush, 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 gush. I love this course. Can you tell? It's so beautiful. This game is beautiful. If you guys don't have a Wii U, why? Buy a Wii U, buy this game, buy Smash Wii U. Beautiful games. You don't have this game? Friggin' buy this game. Even if you have a Wii U and you don't have this game, or you've been like, hey, maybe I should get this game. Yeah, you should get this game. If you guys want to see my first time reaction to it, go ahead and head to the Grand Prix playlist and go to the 50cc Mushroom Cup, and you can see my first ever reactions to playing the game. Well, not my first reactions to ever playing it, because I did actually play it at, like, a convention. I did, like, 2 races, I think, against my dad, and I demolished him. But, yeah. I don't remember. It was a while back. It's weird. I'm not entirely certain when this video is being released, but I don't think it's after May 30th. But this game has almost been out an entire year. This game has been on my channel for almost an entire year. It does not feel like it's been that long. But this game came out May 30th, 2014. And, jeez. It has, and I've got the gold glider twice in that time. Because I got it on my European copy and then on my NTSC copy as well. And there was a banana there. Alright. We're doing pretty badly, actually. I need to pick up the pace here, because I was 50cc, I was just front running, and I was doing perfectly fine. No one to bother me. And now we got friggin' Peach up in here. She's all up in my business. With the fireballs. Wait, was that even her? I don't think that was her. With your silencer, with your ninja swords. Friggin'. What was that, Night at the Museum 3, I think? I don't know why I referenced Night at the Museum 3, of all things. Good movie, by the way. But then again, I enjoy, like, every movie I ever watch. Except the Mario Brothers movie. You killed a good franchise. Thank you. And I know there's people who point out all the things that the Mario Bros. Movie did to, reference the source material and stuff like that, and be similar to the Mario games, but you don't make friggin' Bowser into a human, and Yoshi was a teeny tiny little creepy two-legged crocodile thing, I don't know. And the mushrooms were fungus, it's not right, don't do that to my Mario. I know that's an old movie and I shouldn't really be talking about it, but this is bad. I'm sure everyone's heard that all before, but if any of you guys have not seen the Mario Brothers movie, watch it and tell me how good you think it is. Sorry, I'm yawning. I don't know if you can even hear that, but I haven't been up that long, but I woke up and I was like, oop, DLC? That's pretty much how the DLC Pack 1 update went. I woke up and I was like, oh, DLC. Also, KK Slider was there. I'm guessing this is... I wanna say spring. Is this spring? This feels like spring. Because there's all the friggin' blossoms and stuff. I'm hoping we can actually get all four seasons in the videos. Because we're going to be doing this cup 5 times. So, I hope we get all 4 seasons. If we don't, then... Well, I'm going to, of course, be doing an online races video on this DLC pack. So, maybe I'll get everyone to pick the Animal Crossing course until we get it. Maybe. I don't know. Also, I'm fairly certain that the different villages that appear change every time. Also, wasn't there boost ramps there before? Oh, trick ramps? Hey, Tom Nook, how you doing? I could have sworn that there was trick ramps on the beach before. Maybe not. Hey, KK Slider, how you doing, buddy? And that guy? I don't know. I know that they're the Able Sisters. I know that much. And I saw the blue squirrel guy who you play as in friggin' Animal Crossing Sweet Day on Nintendo Land. Whoa, keep that away from me. Also, something I haven't mentioned, but you can actually see in the trailer for this course. Those trees back there with the fruits in them, if you hit them with an item or if you just drive into them, a fruit will fall out of them, which I think is a nice little detail. So, yeah. Yeah, wasn't there trick ramps here before? Yeah, there was definitely trick ramps there. Maybe the placement of the trick ramps changes. Hello, Tom Nook. Thank you for waving again. Good, sir. You can actually trick off of those. Okay. Rossetti... Leave me alone. I didn't reset anything. I didn't turn off the game friggin' badly. I only just turned it on. I haven't turned this game off yet since the DLC came out. Just leave me alone, dude. Leave me be. And I love the sound for when you collect the bells. It's so good. I love the little sound. I don't know. Honestly, I know that this cart setup thingy has, like, no speed whatsoever. It's got a lot of acceleration. I love the handling. I always love a cart or a setup with good handling, and this thing has good handling. I just wish that good handling didn't mean no speed, because unfortunately it does. We're nearly done. Jeez. Also, those rocks right there, if you drive into them, then a bell will come out. I believe they're called money rocks in Animal Crossing. I could be wrong. Something like that. You're friggin' happy, Isabelle is. Oh, it's so cute. I don't know, I'm being weird. There we go, view results. I can't wait, I know I keep saying it, but I cannot wait to get to 200cc. So far, I have only played the one race that I played before. You know, in the initial version 4.0 video. I'm excited. I'm so excited to get to 200cc. Also, with my new thumbnail design, they probably used something from, like, the highlight reel here at the end, so it's a good job I'm not skipping them. So, yeah. Although I haven't gone back and remade the thumbnails yet for all of the old ones, for all of the old Grand Prix, and I'm fairly certain there was at least a couple where I skipped it. So that's unfortunate. If that is the case, what I'll have to do is play through the Grand Prix again with the same setup, and get, like, a screenshot. I don't know, why am I telling you guys this? You don't care, you're just here for Mario Kart. And there we go, 100cc Crossing Cup, complete, triple star ranking. Admittedly, slightly tougher than 50cc, so maybe they update it? Also, I wanna see. Low speed fun for everyone, picking up speed, high speed thrills, mirror image courses, crazy fast braking is crucial. Oh, I'm excited. And they made the background, like, black for some reason, that's interesting. Anyway, so that is going to do it for this video. Next time we are going to be using Dry Bowser. Oh, look at him. He's like, ha-ha. He's like, yeah, I'm back. Like, he just looks over in the corner of his eye. What does Bowser do? Yeah, I think I might prefer Dry Bowser. And he's like laughing. It's so cool. We're going to be using the Bone Rattler. And yep, we're gonna stick with this stuff. Just for this one, after this next Grand Prix, we will no longer be using the Leaf Tires and the Paper Glider. Actually, I need to look at the stats for that thing, because please be good. Decent. No handling, really, but decent. And I'm going to be taking on the 100cc Bell Cup. So, yeah. That is going to do it Make sure to tell me in the comments what you thought of this video. Leave a like if you enjoyed. Thank you all for watching. Stay tuned for the next video, and I will see you guys then.